Hello, Bea here, and welcome back to Integrated Physics and Chemistry. Well, as you can see, I am in the dark today because the electricity is out at my home. Not a single light working anywhere, so I'm left relying on a few candles. I'm no electrician, but I do have a basic understanding of how electrical circuits work, so maybe together we can figure out what the problem is and get my lights back on. But before we start investigating, let's look at our goals for this lesson. By the end, you'll be able to list and define the main components of a simple circuit, explain the difference between series and parallel circuits, and describe the safety features of large circuits. When you hear the word circuit, what comes to mind? Pause the video for a moment and draw or record some ideas in your notes. What did you come up with? You may have thought of the complex circuit boards that make up computers, or of an electrician working with a large circuit box at a factory. But a circuit can actually be a very simple device made of only a few components. Circuits must always have a voltage source, which can be a battery if we don't want to plug our circuit into an electrical outlet. The voltage source has the energy necessary to push the charges along the circuit. The charges will be pushed through a conductor, which is usually a wire made of copper or aluminum. The circuit must also have some type of load or resistor that uses the electricity flowing through the circuit to perform some task. In simple circuits, this is often a light bulb, but any device that uses electricity would work. While not an absolute necessity, a switch is a useful addition to a circuit because it allows us to easily control the current. One of the most important characteristics of a circuit is that it must be a closed loop. Think of it as a circle with everything connected. Notice that when this is the case, the light bulb turns on. But what if we open the switch? Now we have an open circuit, which does not work because the electrons no longer have a complete path to travel on. Luckily, fixing our circuit is as easy as closing the switch and the lights come back on. So that's how a basic circuit works. It's just wires and bulbs connected to an energy source. Even though the circuits that run your home are larger and have more devices connected to them, they work in exactly the same way. So why isn't mine working? I've tried flipping the light switch again and again and still nothing. So that's not the problem. Let's keep exploring and look at some slightly more complex circuits. The simple circuit we built before had only one light bulb. But what if we need more than one bulb? Can we add it to the same circuit? Let's try. If I add a second bulb next to the first, I have created what is known as a series circuit, because I have two bulbs in a series. The bulbs light up, but do you notice anything different about them? Let's watch the change again. Pause the video for a moment and record your observations. When there was only one bulb, it was bright. But with two bulbs, they became much dimmer. This is because now the bulbs must share the voltage, resulting in each bulb only getting half as much energy, so they only burn half as brightly. When my electricity is working, I have a lot of lights in here. If they were wired in a series and having to split the voltage among them, they would all be very dim. Fortunately, there is another way to wire circuits that allows the original voltage of the energy source to be given to every bulb, even when the circuit has many bulbs in it. A circuit that is wired in parallel gives multiple paths for the current to take. When the switch is closed, both bulbs light up, and unlike the series circuit, they both light up with the same brightness as if there had only been one bulb. This is because in a parallel circuit, the voltage does not have to be shared, and each path gets the full voltage supplied by the source. Homes are wired in parallel for this reason, so that the lights do not have to split the voltage and they can all be bright. But this seems too good to be true. If each bulb uses the full voltage of the source, that's a lot of energy being used. Where does it come from? Well, in the case of your home, the energy probably comes from the power plant, and this simply means that you will use more electricity and pay more for the privilege. If the circuit is running on a battery, the battery will become drained and dead in a much shorter amount of time in a parallel circuit due to the increased demand. As you complete the lesson PDF activities, you will use a simulation to explore what happens when we add multiple batteries, both in series and parallel. You'll also look at the difference between the direction of current and the directions that electrons physically move in a wire. But so far, none of this explains why my lights aren't on. The parallel circuits in my home should give me bright light, not no light. Let's see what more there could be to this circuit. Circuits are extremely useful, when they work, for powering our homes and devices. But circuits can become safety hazards when the current flowing through them becomes too high. This can cause the materials making up the circuit to overheat and catch fire. For this reason, most modern circuits have safety devices built in to prevent the circuit from becoming overloaded. A simple way to protect a circuit is with a fuse. Fuses are made of metals with low melting points, and when inserted into a circuit, will melt and break the circuit if the temperature becomes too high from increasing current. This prevents a fire from occurring, but it does shut off the circuit. Because the metal is now melted, the fuse will have to be replaced before the circuit can become a closed loop again and turn on. I'm pretty sure there are no fuses in my main home circuit though, as they are more commonly used in the electronic systems of cars and individual electronic devices. To protect the circuit of a home, another safety device, a circuit breaker, is more common. Circuit breakers work by the same principle as a fuse, except that when the current becomes too high, the metal only bends instead of melting. This allows circuit breakers to be easily reset instead of needing to replace them. Somewhere in your house, there is likely a box that contains many circuit breakers, corresponding to various rooms and devices in your home. Could a tripped circuit breaker be my whole problem? If a circuit in my home was overloaded, the breaker may have been triggered to open the circuit to stop the flow of electricity and prevent a fire. I'm going to send my friend to the basement to check it out and see if we can get the lights back on. And what do you know? It worked! So it was just a tripped breaker. Do you know what causes a tripped breaker? Circuit breakers can be tripped when your home is using too much electricity at once, and the current coming through the wires becomes too high. I guess it probably wasn't a good idea earlier to be running the hairdryer, vacuum cleaner, washing machine, oven, and air conditioner all at the same time. I'll be more careful from now on, and hopefully won't end up in the dark again. As we went through the lesson today, we saw the main components of circuits. A voltage source such as a battery, wires, switches, and something to use the electricity such as a bulb. We also saw that circuits can be wired in series like this one or in parallel. We also saw that larger circuits have safety devices like fuses and circuit breakers that will stop the flow of electricity if the current becomes dangerously high, even if it means putting us in the dark. Oh, not again! Guess I better go find the candle. Until next time, remember, the universe is vast and full of surprises, so never stop exploring. See you next time. Hey.